Welcome to Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and let's get my Q6600 workstation up and running again. For a secret video ID, I need a faster system. So, we're gonna take my old Q6600, and I use this system from 2007 to 2013, I think. So, pretty long. And it is in this very nice Cooler Master ATC201 case, and I really love this case, and I bought this case in 2001. We have an Asus DVD player, some case badges, including the DPC case badge for the Dutch people under us. Here you see the Core 2 Quad case badge, and Asus, and Fedora, and I never run Fedora, but it looked cool. Corsair. We have a 512-watt Corsair power supply, an HX series, a Salman cooler, and I run this system a really long time with just an Intel stock cooler, but this one is much better. Right now there's an 8800 GTX 786 megabyte video card installed, but this is not a card that I used back in the days, because I use an 8600 GTS 256 megabyte for a long time in this system. And this is a pretty decent mid-range card. At this moment we have two sticks of Kingston HyperX DDR2 for a total of 4 gigabyte, but I have more sticks, so I can run it at 8 gigabyte, but it's not needed for this project right now. So I probably leave this in, or try maybe some other sticks around. Or maybe I gonna try out this OCZ memory. It's PC2-8500. So this pretty decent memory. So there's a lot of options with the memory. This system has an Asus workstation motherboard, the P5WDG2WS Pro. And I really love this motherboard, and it has two 64-bit PCI slots, because I was running it with SCSI back in the days. I think some of the long-time viewers will still remember this system, because I used it in a few videos before. So let's try out if the system still works, and after that I will swap some parts out for the secret project. It turns on, but no display. Oh, yes, there it is. Probably the BIOS battery is empty. The system is missing a hard drive, but I'm gonna install this Western Digital 500 gigabyte 7200 RPM, and I bought this with the system back in the days. For my secret project, the 8800 GTX is not good enough, so I'm gonna swap it out for this GTX 570 from EVGA. And in the last months when I was using this system, I bought this video card to give it some more power. So this system has run with this video card. But one video card is not enough. So I'm gonna put in this MSI with a twin frozen cooler, and this is a GTX 660. So I will use two video cards in this build. That will be interesting. And this motherboard has no SLI support. But still, I need two video cards. But first, I'm gonna try if this OCZ memory will work in this system. Earlier, I tried this Corsair Dominator memory. They are 2 gigabyte sticks each, also running at 8500. But those two sticks won't run in this motherboard. So I don't know if it is a limitation of the chipset, or that maybe this Corsair Dominator is broken. So let's try out if this higher speed OCZ memory will work. And otherwise this motherboard is probably not compatible with fast memory like this. Let's first try just with one stick of memory. Okay, we have display and 2 gigabyte memory detected. So maybe the Corsair Dominator is broken or not compatible. Let's put in the other stick. 4 gigabyte memory detected and dual channel. Nice, the memory is working. So I need to run and mem test still on those OCZ memory modules, but it looks like we have a nice working set. With this Kingston set, I always had an issue that I couldn't run it at higher clock speed. So I always ran it at 666 instead of 800. Let's put the hard drive here in this lower drive bay. I hope it will fit because this case is pretty small and crowded. Now comes the tricky part, and that is installing the video cards, because I only have 2 6 pins and I need 4. So I need to use this terrible Molex 2 6 pin adapters. But luckily we have enough Molex on the power supply, so that won't be an issue, and the power supply is enough wattage, and I only have one DVD player and one hard drive. So that will work out. So let's install the cards. And I really hate the PCI lock system, because I can't reach it. Here we have the 8800 GTX, and as you can see, I still need to clean it, but the brand is Asus, and it's a really awesome card, and it is an 8800 Ultra. Okay, now the video card's out, we can swap out the BIOS battery. Let's first install the second video card, the GTX 570. And the 660 Ti comes in the first slot. I probably have a cooling problem right now, because the case doesn't have that good cooling. But it will okay for the video. I think this is a metal plate. And it's a little bit bent, so I need to put something in between here so the cards won't touch and short out. I cut this piece of rubber here with double-sided tape, and I'm gonna put it in between the cards. So that's better, so it won't short out. So let's put the 6-pin connector from the power supply on the GTX 660 Ti. And the Molex adapters will go on the 570. And I will warn you, this build will be a cable management nightmare. Okay, I think everything is connected now. Let's try out the two video cards. Okay, that is working. Let's set the BIOS. We have a Q6600 running at 2.4 GHz. So let's go to advanced, jumperless configuration, CPU frequency. This is stock, so let's go to... Hey, why is the plus key not working? I think I'm gonna swap out keyboard. Okay, that's better. Let's go to 333. Let's do DDR2 888. So it's on the safe side, because the memory is way faster. Okay, we have a Q6600 running at 3 GHz, and I run it for 6 years like that. But the USB controller in Lysing is failed. And the system is crashed, so maybe the memory controller doesn't like the higher speeds. Overclock failed. I think the memory... Let's put it on 666, because that's the setting I know is working for sure. And otherwise we put the Kingston memory back. Oh, we have still Linux installed. Wait, is this the installation of the last video with this system? That would be funny. We have some video file here. I think it's for my old camera, so let's see what we have here. Oh, some clip which I probably filmed out of the truck. It's not playing back smoothly. Let's open it with Gnome Player. Oh, this a little bit better. Here I'm driving on Schiphol and I'm not sure why I'm filming this. Okay, I found my one of my Ultimate Boot CDs back from 2016. Okay, this is not the installation what I was thinking from the last video, but some random stuff. But I don't gonna run Linux on it, because I gonna run Windows XP 64-bit on it. Oh, nice! We have also 2003 server on it, and I had some IDs with it. Nice that I have it. I forget it already. Let's do the X64 Corporate Edition. So let's start the install. Nice, hard drive is detected, so I don't have to use any drivers. Okay, Windows XP Professional 64-bit is now installed. Let's see, I hate the start menu of Windows XP, so let's go to the classic start menu. That's much better. Yes, all the memory is detected, the speed of the CPU. That's normal VGA adapter. Okay, I need to install some drivers. So I probably will search for the original drive CD of the motherboard and install that, because for the purpose of that video we don't have to have all the updated drivers. The hardware with the Q6600 is running again, but Windows XP and the drivers need to be installed. But it is getting a bit late now, so I think I'm gonna end this video and do all the driver stuff offline, because that's pretty boring to put in a video. And when I show this system again, it will be in a pretty epic configuration. I don't gonna say what my secret video is about, but I have done something like it before, but I gonna do it now even better. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook and you can support me monthly on Patreon.
The time is 8:47 a.m. Current topside temperature is 93 degrees, with an estimated high of 105. The Black Mesa compound is maintained at a pleasant 68 degrees at all times.